So I was saying, well, this is only the second installment of the 8th anniversary of the Church Days in Dubai. Second phase, because we have taken a transformative journey in launching the Bush program. Planting, update, yeah, stabilize, and harvest. As a call, we would like to challenge everybody in the church to actively participate in following the Great Commission. That is sowing seeds of faith and nurturing the growth of everyone. And drawing the inspiration from the parable of the sower in the book of Mark chapter 4, kung matatandaan niyo po ang preaching ni Pastor Rico, his sermon last August underscored the significance of unwavering faith. He exemplified this with the story of the mustard seed, emphasizing the power of belief to manifest extraordinary outcomes. Pastor Rico further highlighted the importance of patience and perseverance, urging us to all maintain faith even in the face of adversity. But beyond faith, Pastor Rico also emphasized the virtues of forgiveness and, of course, love. He encouraged us to extend forgiveness to those who have wronged us and to love even more our enemies. Ang hirap po, ano? But by practicing these principles, we demonstrate our faith in God and align ourselves with His divine example. The sermon serves as a powerful reminder of the importance of planting and nurturing seeds of faith within our hearts. These seeds, nourished by prayer, Bible study, fellowship, worship, and other practices, take root in the fertile soil of our receptive hearts. It's through this process that we cultivate strong spiritual growth and bear abundant fruit. Kaya po kanina, ayan, dumating na po. If you had noticed earlier, the blank canvas in easel, it was placed there on purpose. Because we'd like for the canvas to tell you a story. That's the beginning of all the program, the initiative of GICM Dubai. And as we reflect on our journey since the launch of our PUSH program, we witnessed the transformation from earlier an empty canvas to now a landscape. At kung makikita po na lahat, meron na po mga sprouting seeds.
Amen. The Lord.
Amen. You see here one on top of a rock. Pero hindi po siya nag-sprout. Beside it is one that started sprouting, pero hindi nagtuloy. Kasi baka wala masyadong nutrient since it's beside the rock. There was actually one here. Pero baka tinuka ng ibon. It flew away. Kasama na isa. Hindi natin alam kung saan po dinala. But one, as you can see, is sprouting healthy next to a steak. And of course, we know who this steak represents. Our Lord God.
Right.
Amen?
Amen.
Ito po yung story na gusto namin bahagi sa inyo. Ang story po ng GIC in Dubai. And today, once again, we welcome for the second installment, Pastor Rico Blevens-Ada to share more insights, but this time on the final stage of the full season of planting, cropping, that is the harvest. Church, let us all welcome on stage Pastor Rico Levy.
Amen, praise God. Let's keep the Lord clapping on, amen. Can you say to that person on your left and your right, you're so black? With no offense from our brothers from Cameroon and from other churches. Okay? Our brothers and sisters here on this side, the workers of JICM, let's give the Lord a clapping hand. You don't have the best view of me because you are looking at the side view. The best view here. Amen. Do I have any paper or something?
Praise the Lord.
So first and foremost, we thank God for this wonderful time that once again we can be together. And finally, I guess I will not say finally because the work of the Lord always continues. Hindi po natatapos ang trabaho ng Panginoon.
Amen.
Hindi po natatapos ang gawain ng Panginoon. The work of the Lord will not stop until He comes back again. So if you are thinking that once you are reach a certain age like myself, nasa 50 ano na po tayo, something, no? Sabi ko, magkakaroon na po tayo ng retirement. But in the Lord, there's no retirement. The only time that you retire is when the Lord comes, if ever you're still alive. And I hope and I pray that we will be doing so much work before the Lord. It's always an opportunity for me to stand here to share the Word of God in humility with all of you. Last August, we have started the season, or let's say the program, as what our dear brother said, or our dear elders have said, about PUSH 24. So therefore, I would like to take it from there, and I'd like to really emphasize something that God wanted us to understand. But before that, let me just say a blessed anniversary, second part, to all of you. Amen. Last, if you were not here August, the theme, or at least the attire that they have, mas mukha po silang mga busbusin. They were wearing their farmers attire. Ngayon po, dahil po sa uso na ang gold, naka-gold and black po sila. So it only means that God is a God of progress and a God of victory. Amen? So pag-tapin natin ang Panginoon. And of course, we welcome all our pastors from different churches, from Abu Dhabi, Pastor Dan, Pastor Joy, our pastors from Ajwan, Pastor Wendell, I don't know if our dear pastor is also here, from Sarja po, Pastor Rosen, Pastor Randy is here. Okay? Mahilis yung palakpakan. Palakpakan na ng puso. Of course, our pastors and elders in Dubai, pastors from Al Ain, of course, Pastor Pablo, of course, and Pastor Eden, and some of the pastors are not here today, but we welcome you in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. So let's get on to this because I'm really excited. Actually, I was here since Friday. Hindi ba siya excited, tama? Nandito na po kami sa hotel, nandito nung Friday pa. Nag-absent na po ako, sabi ko sa Mrs. Ko, doon na tayo para ma-feel natin kay Lord kung ano talaga ang gusto niya sabihin. Because harvest, brothers and sisters, is no joke. Some of us see harvest as a product of our effort. But today you will see something more than your effort. But this is God's way of saying, I am in control. So today we will understand not only that God has placed some work in us that's only secondary, but God has already placed His work on His harvest. So whether you like it or not, whether today you come out of this place and say, well, this thing is not for me, God will still reap the harvest because He is the Lord of the harvest. But I want you to take part of it. We want to take part of it, and we want to be the people that God will use for us to be able to fulfill His desire for each and every one. Our title, The Full Season, PUSH 24, Mark chapter 4, verse 15 to 20, that was last August. But today we will focus on Mark chapter 4, verses 26 to 29. So I would like to invite all of you to just stand up right now and let's read. Yung hindi pa po marunong magbasa, mag-lip sync na lang. Amen? Ayoko po talaga ng formal eh, kasi walang humingiti eh. Well, harvest joy. It's a joyful thing. So let's read Mark chapter 4, verse 26 to 29. Let's all read together. It says there, He also said, this is what the kingdom of God is like. A man scatters seed on the ground. Night and day, whether he sleeps or he gets up, the seed sprouts and grows, though he does not know how. All by itself, the soil produces grain. First the stalk, then the head, then the full kernel in the head. And as soon as the grain is ripe, he puts the sickle to it because the harvest has come. Let us pray. Father God in heaven, we thank you, Lord, for the reading of your word today. Father, right now, Lord God, we just invite your Holy Spirit, the spirit of wisdom, the spirit of understanding, the spirit of conviction, the spirit that enable us, Lord, to do your work to the glory of the Father. Apart from you, we are nothing. Lord, today, Lord, we stretch our hands in prayer to all the people that we love and we know. May they be in the Philippines right now, Lord, here in UAE, Lord, in Africa, in the States, wherever they are. Lord, we pray for your provision and your protection to be upon them. Today, Lord, we absorb your word according to what you want us to do. Therefore, Lord, we claim that today we will come out of this place bringing unto our hearts, Lord, your word. Let us not be doers, let us be just hearers of your words, but doers of your word as well. Father, once again, we just want to give you back all the praises, the glory and honor that you deserve. For this we pray in Jesus' mighty name. All God is to say, amen and amen. You can all be seated. Praise the Lord. Mark chapter 4, verse 26 to 29. Now again, let me just repeat this. He also said, now Jesus said in the book of Mark, this is what the kingdom of God is like. So therefore, it's a parable. A man scatters seed on the ground night and day, whether he sleeps or he gets up, the seed sprouts and grows. And though he does not know how, look at that word, he does not know how. All by itself, the soil produces grain, first the stalk, then the head, then the full kernel of the head. Now, as soon as the grain is ripe, he puts the sickle to it because the harvest has come. Now, Mark chapter 4, verse 26 to 29, it's the double scripture that GICM's leadership have, you know, or God has put in the GICM leadership as a vision of the church. I'm sure it's not just for this year, but the years to come. And we took off from Mark chapter 4, verses 15 to 20. This is what our dear elders have said to us, the parable of the sower. I will not read through this because I know that you already know this. And this is what we have. It's like, you know, all these parables of the sowers and so on and so forth. This was the first part. So today, we will take from this what we have learned. The vision of GICM, and I think it will be now the whole ICM for this matter. Grace ICM embarked on what we call PUSH. And I think our pastor or our elder said, it is planting, uptake, stabilizing, and harvest. But if you put a definition here very quickly, planting is a noun. It means putting seeds or young plants in the ground to grow. The planting of corn is hard work. You know, that this is what we call insemination. Now, the word uptake, which I'm sure in between August and now, it is the action of taking or making use of something that is available. God is giving us resources. God has given us people. God used these people for us to avail for these things to take the absorption or the substance for which this seeds to grow. Then we have the word stabilize. Stabilize is a verb. It means to make stable, steadfast, or firm. That is the effort that you have been doing probably for the last 3 months or months to come. And today, we are highlighting harvest. Harvest is the gathering of ripening crops. That's what it's all about. Now, in retrospect of affirmation of what we have learned, how many of you were here last August? If we want to have a retrospect of affirmation, we talk about the parable of the sower. We know that in Mark chapter 4, verse 14, NIV and King James Version, the farmers sow the word. So there are jobs that God has given to each and every one of us. The sower's job, brothers and sisters, was not to inspect the soil. That's why we really categorize our role in what we call the planting season. The sower's job was not to inspect the soil. He will not go there and check each and every soil. Sowers are there to simply to scatter the seed and ensure that the ground is adequately covered for the great harvest to come. We need to understand when we use the word parable or when we use the preaching parable of the sower, there are so much categories, because in the line of, let's just say, harvest or planting, the first part is what we call plowing. Say to the person you're left and you're right, plowing, without an F. Without an F, huh? Plowing. Plowing. What is plowing? Plowings are people, or at least it's an activity for people who till the soil. Now, after plowing, there is what we call sowing and planting. That's where the sowers is. So that's why, brother and sister, each and every person that God has called in his vineyard are important and has roles for us to be able to complete what God wanted us to do. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, may role ka. Kontrabida nga lang. So we have plowing. Yung plowing po, sila yung nagtitil ng soil. Sila po yung nag-check ng soil. Yung po mga sowers, they are the ones who scatter the seeds. And then we have you hoeing and weeding, sowers also. There's the sowers, which is part of what the church is called. And of course, the harvesting, which is a collective role of each and every one of us. This is the in-gathering. In the scripture, how did I say this? Because in the scripture, it says there, in Ezekiel chapter 36, verse 9, it says, "Behold, I am for you, and I will turn to you, and you will be what? Cultivated." So there is an activity of tilling. And sown, there is an activity of planting. I hope you understand where I'm coming from. That's why, brothers and sisters, we respect each and every word that God has, you know, instilled in our hearts. Furthermore, in Isaiah 28, verse 24, it says there, "Does the farmer plow continually to plant seed, or does he continually turn and harrow the ground?" So here, the word of God is simply telling us, we have work to do. There will be people who will be asked by God to move out, whether here or abroad, to till the soil. And there are people like you and me who God has planted here for the last how many years of our life to sow the seed. Are you hearing me? Importante po tayong lahat sa gawain ng Panginoon. If we do not understand that, we do not know what to do. So therefore, today, we will focus now on what God has done unto us. Harvest. Let me start with a story. You like story? Sabi mo sa katabi mo, gusto ko ng chismis. Ay, story. Let me start with this. I'm sure you are familiar with this kind of image. Amen? Pag nakita niyo may isang bata, there's one boy or one lad climbing up a so-called tree with gold and so forth and that. We associate this story to Jack and the Beanstalk fable story. And I'm sure you know the story. Amen? Anybody here does not know the cuento of Jack? I will not completely tell you the story, but I'll just highlight. So Jack is a lad living with her mom, you know, in a certain farm. But because there's a depression, there is starvation, there is, you know, maybe there is a drought, they only have one, let's just say, asset that is left. And that is a cow. Alam niyo po yung cow? Ituro mo yung katabi mo. Ikaw. Yeah? Are you there? Wala yun. Yeah. Okay? Cow. So si Jack po, okay? Si Jack po, inutusan ng nanay niya. So her mom said, "We don't have anything to eat anymore. And our cow stops producing milk. So therefore, there's no use for this. So please bring him to the market and sell him. Jack, being a good son, and of course a little bit stubborn, he decided to bring the cow to the market to sell it. On his way, to cut the story short, he met a man, an old man. Old man said, "Hey, what are you gonna do with the cow? The cow?" Sabi niya, "Well, I'm on my way to the market to sell this because we will be dying if we don't have any more money to buy food for us." So the old man said, "Guess what? I will gladly trade this bag." Meron po siyang bag na pinakita. "This bag for your cow." And then Jack opened the bag and he saw seeds. And this guy said, "Wait, these are not ordinary seeds. These are magical seeds." Amen? Magical seeds. Really? So being a young man, Jack was so impressed. "Give it to me. You can have my cow. Ikaw na, sa'yo na to. Amen? But give me the seed." Now, I want you to understand this. This must be a children's story, but we will equate it with what the Word of God wanted us to learn today. So give me that. And give me the bag of seed, that magical seed. And I give you the cow. So, in short, there was a trade-off. So, Jack went home. Amen? Jack went home and said to my mom, "Guess what, mom? I'm so happy. Guess what happened to the baka? I exchanged it for a bag of magic beans or seeds." Of course, being a mom, sabi na kay Jack, "Subada. What do you want us to do with these seeds?" So he got angry with Jack. Afternoon na po yun. Nakalita po niya. So he scolded Jack, said, "This is no use. This is useless. This is nothing for us." So what happened next is this. So the mom decided to throw the seed at the backyard. You know the story? Amen? Pagbuha po yung mga bata dyan. Kailan po yung mga bata rito? Ayan, yung mga nag-amen. Sinungaling. Amen! So, the mom threw the seed back at that farm, a little bit, a small farm at the back of their house. And then told Jack, "You better sleep. And we better have something by tomorrow." And guess what happened? Jack slept. He slept. He couldn't care. I made a mistake. My mom scolded me. The bag of seeds has been thrown away. Who cares? But guess what? Some of you are familiar with the story. In the evening, the seed starts to sprout. Amen? First, it's, small seedlings. Then it started to sprout. And then it becomes bigger and bigger. It reaches to the heavens, as they say. Now, I will stop here because the story can go on and on. Like Jack met the giant and had the golden goose. Karamihan sa mga kababaihan dito, let's go to the golden goose. We will not go there. We will go to the seeds. Now, the Jack and the Beanstalk story, brothers and sisters, was an English fairy tale. It is a story of Jack Spriggins and the Enchanted Bean, written in 1734 AD. It means 1734, first century. And then it becomes immortalized by Benjamin Tabards during the 1800s. Okay? So it was written 1734, 1800. Let's go to our scripture. Mark chapter 4, verse 26 to 29, was written in the year of the popularity of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, or at least was narrated by Jesus himself in 32 AD. Now look at this. The principle of Jesus Christ is more than what you can ever think of. Are you here? If you read this story right now, I can right now probably associate the Jack and the Beanstalk even better. Because why? Because it is in our time. But 32 AD, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ have illustrated this principle already. You see how God is? God is, will never change. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. He said there, this is what the kingdom of God is like. He scatters the seed at the ground, just like Jack or Jack's mother. She threw away. Who couldn't care less about a bunch of seed, whether it's magical or not? Then night came, day came. He slept, Jack slept. I'm sure the mother slept. And you know what? The seed sprout. Similar to what that story is all about. And then it becomes bigger and bigger until it serves its purpose. Brothers and sisters, I want you to understand that being involved in spreading the gospel message can sometimes be discouraging. Often, it seems like all our efforts, siguro sabi ni Jack, ito na nga ako naman ng magandang loob. Hindi na nga ako namasahe sa pagpunta sa market. Hindi na ako naglugaw, hindi na ako nag-Jollibee. Nagkita na lang kami sa kale, umuwi na ako. But sometimes our effort in sharing the Word of God, okay, sometimes we feel that it is very ineffective and fruitless. Isn't it? Marami po sa atin nag-share ng Word of God. As a preacher, preachers preach the Word of God. And sometimes there is little or no response from either the saints or the sinners. I'm sure after this preaching, the only thing that you will remember is Jack. Hello? Maybe you will not even remember the full essence of this preaching. But you will not so, because I believe that the Holy Spirit will instill the message in your heart. So kahit po kami preacher, ilang taon na po ako nagpipreach ng Word of God. I can see some of you who really started young in the Lord and now you are all pastors. And still, I am here preaching the Word of God. Sometimes there's no response from either saints or sinner. Kung hindi mo patakutin, amen! Hindi pa mag-amen. Amen? Diba? Kung hindi mo pagulatin eh. Amen! 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 Wala pong response. I'm talking about life's response. Now, the message of life, I want you to understand this. The message of life is shared with those who are dead in sin. And they reject it out of hand. Ilang po sa inyo nag-share na ng Word of God sa mga taong alam natin kailangan ng salita ng Diyos. The only thing that they can tell is this, not time. This is not the time. Well, why are you interfering in my life? I don't need whatever you are talking about. The light of salvation is given to those in darkness. And sometimes those people, they prefer darkness to light. This is the reality before we even go to the harvest. Because brothers and sisters, I want you to understand that harvest has nothing to do with you and me per se. It is something to do with God Himself. You labor in the Word for hours. Ilan po sa inyo share ng share ng Word of God? May iba po tayong mga missionaries here who go to other places to share the Word of God, seeking the message of God for His people. And then when the message is preached, you know what? No one cares. Amen? I hear missions report from our church. You know, isang linggo sila sa isang place. They come back and say, isa lang ang tumanggap. Hello? There's only one person that accepted Jesus Christ. Some of you have been toiling in your office areas sharing the Word of God. And until now, no one is accepting the Word of God. Isn't it? Yeah. You labor for hours. This can be very, very discouraging. Isn't it? Wala ba? Ako lang po minsan na di-discourage? Some of you are in the business of sharing your faith. Tama? Matsiklasik. Pag nakakakita ng tao, share agad ng word. Why? You share your faith with your friends, your family, your coworkers, and guess what? What's happening? When you do, especially sa family natin, what's happened? You are ignored. Ilan po sa inyo na ignored na? Hindi ka na pinapansin. Dati sikat na sikat ka sa office, right? When you know, oh, this guy is good, this guy is like this, then you start sharing the word of God, nobody wants you. Kaya nga, wala pong gusto mag-share ng word of God eh. I remember people who are supposed to be content creator. How many of you are working like that? Content creator. Diba? Lahat kayo. Amen? Wala yan kang kausap. Amen? Ayun, nagtuturo yung isa. Ito. Tapos, you will be so proud to say, I have reached 1,000 followers. Brothers and sisters, if you are really sharing the word of God, one will probably more than enough to follow you. It only shows that you're not probably sharing Jesus. You're sharing contents. Yung kinain mo, yung sinuka mo, yung pinautang mo, yun ang gusto mga tao eh. Kaya 1,000 followers meron ka. Try Jesus. Baka mamaya, wala ka pa. Tama? Some of you are in this business. So what do you do? You are ignored. You are ridiculed. You are attacked. And this can be very, very discouraging. The people that you love, the people that you desire to see saved, seems though they could not care less about what you have to say about the condition of their soul. That can be discouraging, isn't it? Hello? Am I talking here reality? Diba? Tapos ngayon ay harvest tayo. Papakita ko lang po sa inyo kung bakit. So today, I want you to understand that in spite of all discouragement, similar to what God has said to us in Mark chapter 4, whether you sleep, you wake up day and night, there will be something that will grow supernaturally if we know that that seed is from God. Ilan po sa inyo ang di-discourage minsan? Amen? Dati mainit na mainit ka. Your church is growing vibrantly. Then all of a sudden, it stops. You don't know what happened. But today, we will know exactly what God wanted us to do. If I'm gonna have a subtitle of our today, it will be this. The seed that produced the harvest. Can you say that to the person you're left in the night? The seed that produced the harvest. Because I want you to come out here knowing the essence of harvest. I'm no farmer, but I know and I want harvest. Because it looks like a festive, a joyful, a victorious occasion. But it's not you. It is God. This parable that we have read today, brothers and sisters, offers us hope. Who, for those who take time to really share their faith with others. Kaya po kayo nandito ngayon, hindi lang para magsuot yung napakagandang damit nyo. Yung iba po dyan, palagay ko, buy one take one, kasi magkakamukha. Okay? Uy, sabi ng isa, uy, parang tayo? Saan mo nang pili yan? Ay, doon dito doon pinili! Magkano? 20? O baka dyan, 30. Eh, mas malaki ka ng konti. Hello, are you there? I love to see the beauty and the, let's just say, the opulence of each and every one of you. But today, this will be an encouragement for us to really know what the harvest is all about. The parable that we heard today teaches us that the gospel is the seed of power. Let me repeat that. The gospel is the seed of power. It is not your program. Yes, thank God for programs. It is not your giftings here in this church that brings about the harvest. The harvest is the gospel, because the gospel is the power that God has placed in that seed. It teaches us this. Now, while we may not see the immediate results, tatlong buwan na lang tayo since we launched PUSH, right? August, September, October, November, December. Sorry, 5 months, right? Will you see results? Maybe you see trickles of results. Maybe you see small results. And maybe some of you are discouraged by the result. But I want you to understand that we may not see the immediate results for our effort, but the gospel, the seed that we will talk about, will bear fruit in God's perfect time. Amen. Are you there? You know, when the gospel is shared, let me just explain this to you. When the gospel is shared, whether it is from here, from the pulpit, or, you know, or personal witness, which you, most of you are doing, a mysterious process, praise God. A mysterious process begins to what? Take place. Pag tayo po nagsishare, meron pong supernatural thing that is happening. Amen? Iba pong klase ang salita ng Panginoon. The process is a sovereign work of God. Pag nag-share ka po ng gospel, brothers and sisters, whether you're eloquent or not, whether you're an English-speaking person or not, whether you are, you know, you're a person who have so much knowledge, once the gospel is shared, there is a supernatural thing that is happening that is beyond you. Ilan po sa inyo dito magaling mag-English? Hello? Wala yata eh. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, I English you. You English me. We English together. Ibang hirap. That's why we opted to most of us share the word of God to Filipinos. Kasi, pwede ka mag-Tagalog eh. Diba? Pag yung iba ng lahat. Ha? No split. Buti nga sa'yo, sa nose lang, si Jesus Christ nga, saka may pinierce pa rito. Bleeding, ikaw sa nose lang. Hindi ka ba makapag-share? Why? Because this is how we see the gospel. It is your power. Yan ang tingin mo. What does the word of God says? The gospel is the power of wala? The gospel is the power of God to the salvation of those who will believe. See that in the scripture? It is the power of God. Now, how many of you are more powerful than God? Meron ba dito mas malakas pa sa Diyos? So if the gospel is the power of God, let God do the work. I cannot outpower. I cannot even outpower my wife. Pag sinabi ko sa wife ko, gusto ko nito! Titingnan ka ganyan. Ano ang gusto mo? Now, can you imagine the power of God? The gospel is the power of God. Unless you believe that you can do better than God, go ahead! The process is often hidden. Just like Jack, nung natulog siya, yung nanay niya, tumugo po yung the process is often hidden from us, from the view of men. Yet these results change with life. Are you following me? I'm trying to establish something here. Para paglabas po natin, that confidence in Christ Himself is with us. I'm not here to preach the program of GICF. That's your way of doing things. But I'm here to make sure that when we get out of here, we believe confidently in Christ alone. Amen? So number one, Number one, the seed that produced faith. Number one po, there is a steady work of faith in harvest. Pag nag-harvest po tayo, may steady work of faith. It in verse 26 to 27, in Mark chapter 4, let's go to that. In Mark chapter 4, 26 to 27, he says there, he also said, Jesus said, this is what the kingdom of God is like. A man, look at that word, a man scatters seed in the ground. Now remember the word here, like the word sower. Now the word from Greek comes from the word balo. Sabi mo sa mga katabi mo, balo. Ano ibig sabihin ng balo? Walang asawa, namatay. Ganun ba? Balo, it means to throw, to cast, without care. Or in some instances, it is a term that implies placing it with an intention. Now, the word scatters, although it comes from the word sow, or balo, sower, it means to throw away or to throw. Remember the parable of the sower? That sower is the most unprofessional sower I ever heard. Nagtatapon siya sa seed sa semento. Hello? Wala natang kausap eh. Tama? Saan niya tinapon? Sabi na punta daw dun sa mga batuhan. Eh naman, kung ikaw ay sower, magaling ka, bakit mo dun itatapon? Mafi mo. Amen? You know why? Simply because a sower scatters seed everywhere. And we already talked about this. I don't want to repeat this last time. So, the man scatters seed. So kahit saan po, pwede natin gawin ito. God wanted us to do. Now, Jesus, he depicts the farmer sowing seed in his field. Then when he has sown the seed, he has done all he can do. Nung pong iniscatter niya na po yung mga seed, ano pong ginawa niya? Hindi po niya inupuan at hinintay. Kailang kaya ito lalago. He do his regular work. Amen? Nag-share ng word ngayon Friday at ngayon Sunday. Now, hindi ko po iisa-isahin kayo as much as I wanted to. I will leave that to God. Are you here with me? Like the sower, he scattered. Remember our vision? Not only the 1040 window, we have a point blank. And this is this. This is where the nation God has brought you from. And it is our business to sow the seeds here. Amen? So ano first point natin? The farmer, when he saw in faith. Harvest starts with faith. Are you here? Kung gusto mo po ng harvest, umpisahan po natin sa pananampalataya. Naniniwala ako na may gagawin ng Diyos na higit sa nalalaman ko. Amen? Wala itong pausap. Amen? Amen? That's the unlimitless power of God! Sino nagkakalain na si Pastor Joy na dating adik, kanyari lang ha, di ba para nanonood ka ng TikTok, ang nanay ko po, dating adik, napapanood niyo yun? Hindi po adik si Pastor Joy. But he has a lousy life probably. A sinful life. A life that is not pleasing before the Lord. But someone shared the gospel in his life. And guess what? How many years later, that seed sprouted and harvest came in. It might not be the same guy who shared that word to you a few years back. But it is the same God who made that seed for you. And kaya wag ka manghihinayang dyan sa katabi mo? Tingnan mo yung katabi mo. Kung tanong mo sa tumanggap ka na ba kay Lord? Sabi niya, oo. Patanggapin kita ulit. Do not be dismayed if you share to someone and that person just completely probably rejected it or if not, just so cold about it. Tama po ba? I'll give an example. In my profession, I'm an architect, similar to your senior pastor. I'm an architect by profession. I receive a lot of application forms. Amen? Ang dami. Nag-a-apply ng ganito. Meron pa nga nag-a-apply. Whatever job available. Hello? Nakakawa na kayo ng ganong application. Imbis na applying for a position of an architect, whatever is available. And because I'm receiving so much, brothers and sisters, but I make sure I read it. This is one thing I'd really like to do. I read it. And then, I keep it. Kasi dami. Sometimes I don't even remember. But one day, I am in need of someone. And all of a sudden, I remember, I read somewhere, there is somebody who is applying for any job available. No, I mean, sorry, as an architect. Hello, ano din? Wala natang kausap dito. Buhay pa ba kayo dyan? Natulog ba kayo kagabi? Okay, mabuti naman. Nandito po yung mga workers ng GICM sa kanan. So I remember, I saw in an application form that there is this one person who has this talent, who has this skill, who has this qualification. Where is that? You see how God says, I remember your hair. Ano na kayo, Lord? Huwag ka maghinayan. Yung sinishare mo ngayon, ayaw. Baka sa ibang church siya pumunta. Huwag ka mag-gather. So kami nag-share na punta sa iba. Ano ba yan? Fishers of men. Ang mga church na yan. Hello? Last. Wala pong ganyan sa salita na ba? Amen! Sa ICM po, walang ganyan. Amen! Amen! Hindi po tayong matakaw. Hindi po tayong matamon. Whatever God wants, it is His word. Huwag niyo naman ipamigay. Mga leaders, ha? Baka kung saan mapunta kasi. Okay lang ko sa Christian church who believe that Jesus Christ is God, triune God, and all these things. Depende na punta sa kulto. The farmer's work is all about faith. I'm faithful. I like to believe that there will be a big harvest. Ano man ang ginagawa natin? Amen? Maraming kinumita po, wala ngayon. Amen? Right? How many of you invited somebody but they are not here today? Amen? Paano po nandito? Ako rin wala eh. Hello? When you sow a seed into the kingdom of God, God asks you to water it. Not water. I want to explain this. This is where most of us pastors or preachers are wrong. We don't water the seed. We water the soil. There's a big difference. Hello? Hello? Kasi po yung iba, we water the seed. You cannot water. You cannot make the seed grow. It is God's prerogative. Bakit po? Kasi mamaya makikita mo that the seed is Jesus Christ himself. You can water it with your faith, the soil. You can sleep and wake up tomorrow and the harvest will grow without you doing anything else. Are you getting the point here? You know why? Because natural laws follow spiritual laws. The law of God is this. The seed is mine. You cannot do anything in the seed. Oh, well, gagawin ko ng artificial seed. Yung iba mga ginagawa pang seedless. Ang gospel po ng Diyos ay sa Diyos. Are you hearing me? We cannot naturalize the supernatural. Anything of the Holy Spirit, brothers and sisters, is subject to God. Are you hearing me? That's why I came from a very Pentecostal background. Church of God. We believe in all the gifts of God or gift of the Holy Spirit applicable. Amen? Sana po naniniwala din ang church natin doon. Healing, laying of hands, teaching, even gift of tongues. But I cannot teach you gift of tongues. Let the Holy Spirit do it for you. Are you hearing me? I cannot have a session today. Today we'll have a session. I'll teach you how to give of tongues. Although we can encourage people to seek God, open their heart, let the Spirit of God come to them. But let the Spirit of God manifest the gift that God wanted you to exercise. The best gift. Do you know what's the best gift of God? It's not speaking of tongues. It's not healing. It's not prophecy. The best gift is the gift that works on the hour. Kung may sakit po, kapatid, meron pong pupunta. Okay ka na ba? May sakit pa rin ako. Gift of healing is applicable. Are you here? Encouragement. Worship. Now, I will not come here healing all of you when we're supposed to worship. Let's worship God. Let's speak in tongues. Are you here? Are you following the point? Because the natural laws follows the spiritual. It cannot be the other way around. Kaya mag-ingat po tayo, mga kapatid. How we want things to happen. The seed is God. Your harvest is not your effort only, but more so God's mission for you. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Romans chapter 8, verse 24. Look at this. For the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus had made me free from the law of sin and death. The law of the Spirit in Christ Jesus is much higher. Harvest, brothers and sisters, might be an effort in our part, but it is God, based on our scripture, Mark chapter 4. It is God who will do it for us. So faith is a very important aspect. Verse 3, for what the law could not do, in that it was weak through the flesh. Kaya buwag lang tayo fleshy. God sending His own Son in likeness of sinful flesh for sin, condemned sin in the flesh. That the righteousness of the law might be what? Fulfilled in us by the law of the Spirit that is in Christ Jesus. We work in faith. Our faith in God to do the work in Christ Jesus. Amen! Nag-harvest po tayo, hindi para damihan ang church. Yung pong gusto nating results, right? Amen! Mag-evangelize tayo para dumami ang church. Ang church members pala, hindi dumami ang church. Dumami ang church members. That's good. That's noble. I believe that's what I also want. But I think that's carnal. Maraming amen, isa lang. Yung nag-amen yung walang church pa. We scatter seed for the kingdom. Are you here with me? Kaya huwag po kayong magpapagod. Pagod na ako. Ito na naman. 3 o'clock in the morning, pupunta na yung mga taga-salon. I remember those days, right? Sarja, Pastor Rosen, yung mga taga-salon na nag-out ng 2 o'clock, ba-Bible study yan pa natin. Nakapagod! Nasaan sila? Mga alam, Pastor, hindi ko na alam. But you planted the seed. You planted the seed. The seed of the gospel of God. Amen. Amen. In Romans chapter 5 verse 2, it says there, through whom we have gained access by faith into his grace in which we now stand, and we boast in the hope of the glory of God. Now, I underline the word access by faith. Harvest is an act of faith. Are you here? May pastor, ilan po sa inyo galing sa farmer family? Yung mga mayayaman sa Pilipinas? Mga farmers? Diba? Yeah. Yeah. Lumaki sa farm yan. Talaga kayo, no? Sato kayong... Ayun, alis daw. Sinabi pa yung pangalan talaga. Hello? Harvest is an act of faith. When we scatter seeds, brothers and sisters, we look forward not to our own skills, not to our own effort, but because God will do something on His word. God said it. God said, my word shall not return void. Hello? And iinip ka, Lord, natupad naman yung word mo. How many of you have words here that are void? Yung pangako ka ng pangako, magpapayad, hindi ka nagpapayad. Hello? Ilan po yung voids na ganun? Ama? Bayad ka. Utang mo, bayad. Okay, promise. Pagdating ng day, void. Ha? Kailan? Next month. Next month, void. Tapos hindi mo na siya nakita, avoid. Hello, are you there? Let that house. But the promise of God is this. My word shall not return void, but it will accomplish the task that it was sent for. Sent for the word of God for what? For salvation, and it will not return void. Ako ba nagsabi ko? Kung ako lang, huwag niyo paniwalaan. Tama? Okay ka naman, pastor? Amen. Kung ako lang. Promise, bukas. Ilan po sa inyo promise? promise. Nauubos na yung promise eh. Kaya nga nagkaroon ng salitang promises are need to be broken, but God will not break. His word, now put it in your heart, His word will not return empty. Harap ni Lord. Faith is very important for us to access harvest. Meron ba nagtatanim sa inyo? Tatanim lang ako. Inshallah. Kung tumubo, tumubo. Kung mamatay, mamatay. Ba't ka pa nagtanim? Hello? Last August, you gave me a very special gift. Amen? Binigyan niyo po ako ng bonsai. Thank you very much. Ang mandate niyo sa akin, palakihin ko. Hello? Sa kayo nakakita ng bonsai na lumalaki? Hello? Pinahirapan niyo pa ako. But by faith, sabi ko lang, lalaki to. Alam mo nangyari? Bumili na po ako ng mas malaki. Are you getting it? Once you preach the word of God, brothers and sisters, your word will return empty. But God's word will accomplish its task. Di huwag tayong matakot! Amen! Yan ang baka yung iparap pa kay Lord. Pakainin niyo na nga ito. Kaya po, huwag po kayong matakot mag-share. Parpuntahin tayo. Because without faith, it is impossible to please Him. Tama? Without faith, you think you will have harvest? Wala na kausap eh. Tingnan po sa inyo mga tao, you're doing things without putting your faith on it. Try lang, subukan lang, inshallah we will see. Knock knock on the wood. Diba, may ganyan pa kayo eh. Mali pala, knock on the wood na pala. Huh? Apply ako. We will see. Have faith! Kung sa mundo nga, may faith kayo. In this world, you have faith. Don't you have faith in the God who created all faith? He that come to God must believe that He is, and that He is a rewarder of those who diligently seek Him. Are you hearing me? Yung harvest po natin hindi matatapos ngayong araw na ito. In fact, we are here to even expand that harvest for the glory of God. You know why? Because faith is essential for harvest. Prayer is faith. Amen? Worship is faith. Giving is faith. Preaching is faith. Sowing is faith. Mission is faith. Thanksgiving is faith. Brothers and sisters, natural laws follow spiritual laws. And I keep saying this. We don't worship because we want to unload our burden. Praise and worship team, please try to minimize that kind of enticement of emotion. Brothers, lift your burden to the Lord. Worship. Worship is not unloading your burden. Worship is faith, regardless of your burden or not. Aawit ako sa isang Diyos because of who you are. Are you hearing me? Marami pong worship leader, nobody in particular, mawin po tayo sa Panginoon. I-unload! Ilabas natin lahat! Eh kung wala kang ilabas. Because when you worship, it's faith. I come here, walking into the mountain of Zion. Because God is who He is. When God touches you, let it be unloaded. Don't get me wrong. Tama? Hindi ko sinasabi bawal umiyak. Yung pastor, bawal daw umiyak sa worship. Hindi ko sinasabi yun. Pero bago ka mag-iiyak, recognize God for who He is. Giving is faith. It is not so you can receive more. Hello? Hello? I think we need to hear more about harvest. Giving is faith. I give not because mag-aaway pa tayo kung ito yung Old Testament or New Testament, tithing and so on and so forth. May magsasabi pa, well, don't teach tithes. Let the church learn to give in faith. My question, are you giving in faith? Sino lang siya? You are not. Worship is faith. Giving is faith. Preaching is faith. I'm preaching here not because I'm expecting another bonsai. I hope you change your mind. Yung pinasakit pa yung ulo ko. I'm preaching here because faith. Lord, when they hear the word, they may not join JICM. They may not join ICM. But Lord, one day, you will reap this harvest for that person for your glory. Amen. Amen! Mission is faith. It is not an activity. You go out there because you know that God wanted to do something and He will do something. It is not an activity. Halika, magkaroon tayo ng mission. You know? Mission activity. I say we will have our mission team soon. I invited some mission people here. But we are partnering. We will be sending people out. Amen. And in.
Amen.
And within. And without. Because it is an act of faith. Thanksgiving Amen? Nagpapasalamat ako sa Diyos. Not because I have received so much blessing, but because God is good. Amen? So, ano po yung sabi natin kanina? There is a steady work of faith in harvest. Kung wala kang faith, ano nga harvestin mo, kapatid? Ano na po ngayon? 17? 17? 2 weeks na lang, sahod na naman. How many of your faith? Sasahod na ako sa... Yung mga nagsasabing, inshallah. Tapos hindi nakasahod ka rin. Eh bakit po? Have faith. Kung meron kang faith sa mundo, have faith in God. How many here have come here for the first time? Raise your hands. Ngayon pa lang namin. Huwag po kayo may itaas niyo yung kamay niyo. Meron po kayo premium. Yung mga matatanda na kay Lord, you know, you come here because God wanted you to have something today for your life. Let's go to the second one. So, first, harvest, there's a steady faith. There's steady work of faith. Pangalawa po, and I like this, there is a secret work of the seed. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, I will share a secret with you. Tawa ka ng tawa, I will share a secret with you. Okay? In verse 27 and 28. Are you following me? In Mark chapter 4, 27-28, it says there, ito po sa task kanina, scatter seed. Night and day, whether he sleeps or he gets up. How many of you sleep? Raise your hand. Wala yung iba po. Ano kayo? Insomnia. How many of you sleep? How many of you get up? All of us. It is a part of our life. Yung bang mga natutulog na hindi na gumigising, ipananalangin na namin kayo. Natulog, hindi na nagising, pinamumot. Ewan po, ano nangyari? But night and day, whether he sleeps or not, or gets up, the seed, look at this, the seed sprouts and grows, though he does not know how. Now, this is a very profound illustration of Jesus Christ for the kingdom of God. Now, look at the word. In verse 26, there is the word seed. Amen? Can you see it? Seed. In verse 27, the word seed again comes there. So what is this seed? And this is where the heart of harvest is. Now, the seed in Greek, at least here, that is used here in Mark chapter 4, comes from the Greek word sporos. Sabi mo sa katabi mo, sporos. Ibig sabihin po, literally, seed. Plant seed. So in Mark chapter 4, that's why po, kami po mga preacher sometimes, depending on your school of thought, kung saan ka po na-orient, and depending sa interpretation mo, you associated the interpretation according to the understanding of the word. Right? Because it will, dito, pag tinignan ko po yung Mark in Greek, it says sporos. But don't you know that another word for seed in Greek? Hello? Ano yung isang other word? Sperma. So there is sporos and there's sperma. I will tell you this. Why this is very important for us. Kasi po, why am I saying this? When we talk about harvest, when we talk about sporos, we are focusing much on what we can do. But when we focus on the word sperma, we are focusing on who have done it. I'll explain this to you. In Hebrew, how many here are Hebrews? Wala? Buti naman. Pwede ko kayong bulahin. In Hebrew, brothers and sisters, there is only one word for seed. Diba? Sa Greek, dalawa. Sa Hebrew po, isa lang ang word. Can you see it? And the word is zera. Nakikita niyo po ba? Kung hindi niyo nakikita, Lord, bigyan niyo po sila ng paningin. Then, andito po sa dulo, Zara, hindi po Zara. Yung mga misis po, Zara. Eh? Hebrew word for seed is Zara, which is also can be translated to offspring. Sa Hebrew po, wala pong pagkakaiba, but there's no difference between the word in Greek that is sporas and sperma. Now, why is this important? Matthew chapter 13. See, balik po tayo. Mark 4:26, ginamit po natin yung word seed. When you take this into your translation, it's poros or sporas, which means literally seed. Tama? Pero pag nagtunta ka po sa Matthew 13:24-30, okay? The word here, are you here with me? The word here, Jesus presented another parable to them saying, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to the man who sowed good seed. In Matthew, because Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John are synoptic gospels that are translated from Greek. But the word was used, sperma. Hello? Ano yung difference? Now, hindi ko sinasabing mali yung isa, tama yung isa. But that's how it's used. Sperma. And then the other word there is this. Sir, did you not sow good seed sperma? Now, if you're a teacher of Bible, and so much of us are called pastors sometimes, tapos kung ano na lang naman tinuturo, kaya nahiya ako minsan. I'm so highly regarded of the Word of God. When you use the word sperma and the word sporos, yes, they might mean the same. Because God is, or Jesus is using a parable, right? For you to understand the parable, you should be able to bring down the truth to something that person can understand. But they use the word sperma. Galatians chapter 3, verses 19:24-29. Underscores the whole thing. Why the law then? It was added because of transgression. Having been ordained through angels by the agency of a mediator until the seed, capital letter, sperma. It means the offspring. Church, the seed is the gospel of Jesus Christ himself. Amen. Wala kang mababago sa ginawa ni Jesus Christ. The seed that we are planting, brothers and sisters, you don't need to water it. Because God already completed it. Amen. Kaya nga po, whether you do evangelization, whether you do sharing, whether you do mission, don't lie. Don't rely. Sorry, not lie, but don't rely on your own strength. Don't rely on your approaches. Yes, it's good. It helps. But rely in the person of the seed. That is Jesus Christ. Can you add anything more to what God has done? No! Let me explain this to you. How many of you are botany major? Yung madalas nagbabota. Biology major. O kahit minor. O sige, kahit ano na lang, biology. Ilan po sa inyo dito? How many of you here have master biology? Dalawang taon lang sa college, ginawa mo lima. Hello. Let me explain this to you. That's why whenever I see the word of God, I cry before the Lord. Let's talk about the seed. This is a seed. Amen? gusto rin din. Para pagkain. Simple yan. Lord, baguhin mo mga paningin nila. This is a seed. There are two kinds of seed. According to biology, I will not go into detail because I'm not a biologist itself. I'm an architect. We have a dicot seed and a monocot seed. It means, one yung dalawahan, hindi pong pagbinuman mong dalawa, yung isa-isa lang talaga, hindi mo siya pwedeng buka kasi masisira. A seed is self-processed. Ano nyo ba yun? Ang seed po, self-processed yan. May proseso. There's a process that is going on. Now, why am I saying this? Because I want you to understand that you cannot do anything with Jesus because Jesus has self-processed himself because he is God. Hindi mo na pwedeng dagdagan. Jesus plus others is no gospel. It is self-process. What do I mean? Look at this. John chapter 11 verse 25. It says, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even when he died. Grabe. Saan po natin makikita yun sa seed? Yung seed coat. Ang seed coat po, yan yung nagpo-protect sa seed. The word of God says, until the seed is broken, life will not come out. And who broke himself to us? Christ himself. Ilan po sa inyo mga Jack the Beanstalk hero, may dala-dala. Alam nyo ba, dala-dala nyo yung beans? Dala-dala nyo yung seed? Hindi po yan seed kung saan man. Yan ay gawa ng Diyos. John, ito po yung seed code. Sana po, God will speak to you today. John chapter 6 verse 63. Only, look at the word. Only, so very, very specific. Only the Holy Spirit gives eternal life. Those born only once with physical birth will never receive this gift. But now I have told you how to get this through spiritual life. Jesus. Harvest, kapatid, may dala kang seed. Yung seed na yan. Ewan ko po sa inyo. Ilan po sa inyo dito nagbabitamin sa raise your hand? Meron po lang. Raise your hand nga eh. Alam nyo ba yung kakaiba ng raise your hand tsaka yung amen? Amen po sinasabi. Yung raise your hand ginagawa. Raise your hand, yung nagbabitamins. Ilang vitamins yung iniinan mo? Pastor, meron na po akong butika sa bahay. Have you heard about the multivitamins? Yung tipo pag ininom mo, nandun na lahat. From A to Z. Ayoko pong ikumpara ang Diyos sa multivitamins because nothing created can compare to the God who created all things. But parang ganun po, kumpleto ang Diyos. Nandun yung buong proseso. Yan seed na binibitawan natin. That's why God said, you cannot do anything on it because it will accomplish what it's supposed to do. Ganun ka-importante ang hawak mo. Ganun yung mga kamay mo. Ganyan. Tapos ang ngayon mo. Hindi, ganyan mo. Yung pong seed na nandyan na binigay sa inyo ng Diyos, all you have to do after him. Ano yung second point? Are you with me? Pastor, hanggang ano rin po tayo dito? Next week? Pasensya na po kayo ha. Na-miss ko kayo. Sabi po ni sister kagabi, you know, I saw some of the sisters here last night. 11 o'clock na po yung magpa-practice pa sila. Pastor, we miss you. We haven't seen you for a long time. Don't worry. You will hear from me for a long time. So, self is seed is self-process. Ang Diyos lang ang nakaka-process ng sarili niya, brothers and sisters. Look at this. Look at what what Jesus said to himself, John chapter 10 verse 18. You know what? No one takes my life. I'll just put that line. No one takes it from me. Jesus said, but I lay it down for my own accord. Marami po sa atin, we give our life of our own intention. Correct? Iba yung mga mahal natin sa buhay, binibigyan natin yung buhay natin. Correct? Kaya kayo nandito, tama? That's why you are here. How many here are OFW? Raise your hands. Yung iba po, ano kayo? Bisa po kami. We are tourists. We give our life to the people that we love. Maybe one, if I will interpret this and say, Jesus, we are also laying down our life because of how we feel about others. But look at this. Second part. This is strong. I have authority to lay it down and the authority to what? Take it up again. Wow. I-qualify natin to. Ilan sa inyo pwede magbigay ng kanilang buhay sa minamahal? Friend. Yung pwede nyo ibigay. Kailangan nila ng kidney. Sino po ang pwede magbigay? Ibigay kayo, magmahal mo, tama? Ilan po sa inyo may puso? Nakakailangan po yung mahal mo ng, sa buhay ng puso. Eh, pag-pray ko na lang, Lord. Then, you can lay down your life because that is given to you. But the question is, pagpatay ka na, pwede mo sabihin sa sarili mo, mabuhay ka. Wow! Ang Diyos lang nakagawa niyan! Saan ka ba? He can give his life. That's why people, when they ask me, give me a proof in the scripture that Jesus is God. Well, he didn't probably say, I am God directly, although of course there are implications. But John chapter 8, verse 18 tells you who he is. He gave his life, nabuhay pa. Ilan po sa inyo nagbigay na ng buhay, hindi na nabuhay ulit. Tama? Wala yan pang kausapin. Tama? Oh, yes, yes, daw. The seed is self-processed. Sana hindi ka pa magtugtog, kapatid, ha? Mahaba ba ito? Are you getting something today? Ang harvest po, ganon. Sige, punta tayo sa second one. Bilisan na natin. The seed is self-contained. Wala kang itatagdag sa seed na yan. Why? Look at this. 1 John chapter 5, verse 11 to 13. Apologies po sa mga nandito side. It says there, and this is what the testimony. God has given us what? Eternal life, and this life is in His Son. Whoever has the Son has life. Whoever does not have the Son of God does not have life. I have written these things to you who believe in the name of the Son of God, Jesus, so that you may know that you have eternal life. Seed po natin in Jesus because we have eternal life. Now, how does it work in the seed? Look at this. This is what they call, again, hypocotyl. Ano po yung hypocotyl? Yung hypocotyl na yan, nakita niyo po yun? Yun yung life within that seed, ready to spring out anytime. Ang lahat po ng seed, meron hypocotyl. Even they become a plant. Jesus said, I have given you life for those who believe. Sa kanya po nandun na yung buhay natin. Are you hearing me? Ano po yan? Yung hypocotyl, it is the bark. The bark that gives, that will give life because it's connected to the root. Alam niyo kapatid, yung bawat seed natin, may buhay na yan. Kaya hindi niyo po kailangan dagdagan. Lalagyan ko ng fertilizer. You are not putting fertilizer in the seed. Any one of you right now who tell me, Pastor, I'm watering the seed. I'm putting fertilizers in the seed.
It's wrong. You're not putting fertilizer in the seed. You're fertilizing that soil. Because you cannot fertilize life. Kaya mo magbigay buhay? Oh yes, Pastor, tatlong anak ko na eh. Ano? Iba po yung buhay na yun. Ang buhay po na nasa Diyos. Wala po kayo sa inyo, hindi isa magkapagbigay niya, kundi yung seed na yan. Lalabas po ako dito, sana nga, kung meron man kayong souvenir, Pastor, sana seed na lang ang binigay niyo. Magpapabili po ako ng butong pakon. Amen. Para maalala niyo na ang hawak-hawak na, the one that you have is more than enough for God to move. Ano po yung next? So sabi po natin, self-contained, self-life. But those he has pierced for his transgression, he was crushed for iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace on him, and by his wounds, we are healed. Brothers and sisters, that is the root of each and every sin. Only God has given his life for the salvation of you. Kaya po may harvest, may nagbigay buhay. Amen? Now, I'm not trying to discredit your effort, but I'm just trying to focus your effort to the one who has done everything. Amen? Kalapit na po tayo matapos. Lagi ko pong sinasabi yan, ano? Kung sumobra po, sagot na po ng alin ang babayaran na mapupunta na kay Pastor Pablo. Romans chapter 8 verse 7. Are you getting something? Harvest po. Pastor, parang hindi naman harvest. Harvest po yan! Meron ba sa inyo nag-harvest na hindi nag-plant ng seed? Yung seed po, kala nyo seed ng JICM? Romans chapter 8 verse 11. But if the spirit of him that raised up Jesus Christ from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his spirit that dwelleth in you. Nakatikip na po yung buhay na yan. Kaya kung naniniwala kayo sa buhay na yan, you have to value the gospel of God. The seed is self-generating. Hindi mo mapaparami ang seed ng Diyos. Mapaparami yung resulta, but not the seed. Because the seed is only done by God himself. Ano po, saan po yan? Galatians 5, 22 to 23. But the fruit of the Spirit is what? Love, joy, peace, forbearance, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things there is no law. What do I mean, Pastor? Self-generating. You know that each, every seed, brothers and sisters, they have what they call cotyledon. Hindi pa yung binibili sa Japanese food. Diba? Ano po yan? Cotyledon, brothers and sisters, I want you to understand this. Because minsan hindi po natin tumainam. Akala lang po natin nagbibiro si Kristo nung he gave this parable. This is what? This is the seed bearing that will multiply the very essence of the seed once it grows. Nasa loob po ng seed, yung prutas. Kaya pupunta si Kristo sa atin at ang banal na Espiritu ang nagpalago sa atin. Lalago po tayo ng fruit of the Spirit. We cannot bear natural fruit for the Spirit. Pastor, loving naman ako. Ilan po siya loving? Praise the Lord. Loving conditionally. Di ba? Nung anniversary po ng misis namin, na misis ko pala, namin pala. Kasama ko ng mga anak ko, hello! nung anniversary po namin ng misis ko. Araw na yun, yung pinaka-araw na yun, wala pa akong regalo. Iyang-iya po ako sa sarili ko. So I woke up early in the morning and I went out to buy gift. Pinila ko po siya ng ganito. Hindi ko na po sasabihin sa inyo kasi masyadong mahal. And then, bilang na po. So bumili ba ako nito, bumili ako niya, bumili ako nun. Para surprise. Wala po ako sa bahay, nagising siya. Tapos pagdating ko, kanyari tulog siya. Wala ka ba? Umalis ka. Pagbalik ko po sa bahay, sabi ko, Mami, this is for you. And this is for you. This is for you. Nakaapat ako ng regalo. Siya wala. Yung pong anniversary namin naging Mother's Day. Bakit ko po nasabi sa inyo yan? Brothers and sisters, you can love conditionally. You can have peace conditionally. You can bear things conditionally. Tama? Enough is enough. Tama? Wala, ako lang ba nagsasabi nun? Di ba lahat kayo? Wala ba nagsasabi nung ganun? Tama na ha? Sobra na. But the fruit of the Spirit, forbearance is more than enough. You have goodness. Nagkagaling po yan sa sip. Ang sip po, nandun na po sa loob niya. Pag once siya ay nag-sprout, it will bear its own time. Jesus, the gospel of God, will bring its own kind, and that is the Holy Spirit. Nakita niyo po ba? Ando na lahat. Sa seed na yan. And here we are trying to teach God our ways. 2 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 18. Matatapos na po tayo. Yan ang sakit ko sasabihin hanggang mamaya. And we all who with unveiled face contemplate the Lord's glory are what? Being transformed into His image with ever-increasing glory which comes from the Lord who is the Spirit. Alam niyo kung bakit ganyan na kayo ngayon? Dahil yung seed ng Panginoon sa buhay natin, gospel, is now bearing fruit in your life. Kaya mapagmahal ka na. Tama? Medyo conditional, medyo konti. Pero nagbabawasan na. Tama? Lahat ang kausap eh. Kahit sa anniversary mo, wala ka natanggap. Sa misis mo na lahat, okay lang. Lord, sana po nakikinig. Are you getting the point here? I'm trying my very best by the power of the Holy Spirit in our life for you to see the real meaning of harvest. The seed is of the harvest. Wala pong farmer, no scientist, no philosopher can clearly explain how a dead seed can produce life. But a dead and sacrificial love of God give life to all of us. Let's keep this one. Brothers and sisters, even though we cannot see the process, the seed goes through as it begins to grow. Ganyan ko ka-confident sa natanggap kong Ebanghelyo sa Diyos. We can sow the seed in confidence by faith, knowing that God is in control of what the seed becomes. We are responsible for the sowing, yes. We are responsible for the watering, yes. We are responsible for waiting in faith, yes. But He alone is responsible for its germination and its growth. Amen! Ang Diyos Kaya nga sabi po sa 1 Corinthians chapter 3 verse 6 and 9, it makes sense when Paul wrote to the church of Corinth, he said, I planted the seed. He saw the seed. Then he said, Apollos watered it. Are you following the point? Kaya po yung scriptures, they come together if we understand what it's all about. But God has been making it grow. No. So neither the one who plants, which is Paul, nor the one who waters, which is Apollo, but only God, or nothing, but only God who makes things grow. Pare-pareho po ang theology sa New Testament. The one who plants and the one who waters have one purpose. And they will each be rewarded according to your own labor. For we are what? Co-workers in God's service. And you are God's field, God's building. Brothers, we can rest assured that the gospel seed will accomplish the task that it was set for. Thus, we can sow the gospel. Nakukuha niyo na po ba ngayon? Kaya nga po kung meron tayong kailangan pag-aralan si Jesus sa buhay natin. Yung ginawa ng Diyos sa buhay natin, yan din ang isi-share mo. Hindi yung ganda ng church, ang ganda po ng church natin ngayon, anniversary natin. For the first time po, magkunti na ang pawis ko. Amen? No offense po sa mga taga-sabja. It will prosper according to the Lord's plan. Why? Isaiah 55. Verse 11. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return void or empty, but it will accomplish what I, not me, but what I, Yahweh, has desired to achieve the purpose for which it was sent forth. Amen? Ganun po kaganda ang success ng Diyos. So, last point. Alam ko, Pastor, last na yung last na to. Ito pa madali kayo. Anniversary natin to, harvest eh. Nakapagkita nga kayo ng 5 weeks, a month eh. Alam niyo po bakit gusto ko kayo sa ICM? Pag ako po tolerant kayo sa akin. Pag yung ibang pastor, lagi yung sinasabi, let my people go. Diba? Narinig po yun sa isang preaching. There's a successful work. Ito na po yung harvest. Pero makita nyo kung saan ang upis yung harvest? Faith. Tapos hindi sa'yo, sa Diyos. Kaya kahit anong effort natin, whatever effort we do, brothers and sisters, if it's not Jesus that we are planting, we are nothing. So ano po ang successful work? Mark chapter 4, verse 29. As soon as the grain is ripe, he puts the sickle to it because the harvest has come. Although this might be directly as a parable or a prophetic word of God, it is something to do with what we are expecting from him. There will be a great harvest. All the farmer did was cast some seed. Let me make this more personal. All the GICM Dubai did was to cast some seeds in the soil. You went about your business and a secret work took place. While GICM Dubai went about his day-to-day activities. Are you getting the point? The seed germinated. And that little plant pushed it. Its way to the surface of the earth. The sun, by God's grace, favored the little tender plant with light. The soil provided the plant with nutrients. And the plant grew. It matured. And in time, it brought forth fruit. You see, I'm summarizing the whole thing. When the harvest was ready, GICM entered the field and gathered the crops. GICM, we really didn't do nothing. There was an effort. But God reaps all benefit. Church, never think for a minute that your witness is in vain. You cannot see what God is doing. He is working behind the scenes. Are you hearing me? And beneath the soil, each and everyone's heart, to bring the souls to Himself. If you raise me up, I will draw men to me. The business of saving soul is God's business, not man. Don't get me wrong. The business of saving soul is God's business, not man. We are here to usher that, but not to take it out from whom who has given life. Brothers and sisters, I can preach as good as I'm able. Amen? Siguro nagsasawa na kayo. Feeling ko next year, di yan ako imbitahin. Lord, change their hearts. I can preach as good as I am able. As hard as I please, and as often as I have the opportunity. Bigyan niyo ako ng chance, I will preach the gospel. But I cannot save a single soul. If I am faithful to sow and water when I'm given a chance, the Lord will take care of saving. What God is asking from you is your faithfulness and your perseverance. I am not wasting my time today. My wife knows I cannot even sleep. 3 days. Ay ko, Lord, ngayon ako, hindi makatulog ha. Pag nag-preach ako, Lord, three weeks ago, I was invited to another church in Ajman. Sabi siya, sarap ng tulog ko. But this time, 3 days. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Hindi ko po kasi masakitan dyan ko. Thank you po yun. But Lord is just simply telling me, are you talking about me? What can you do? I am not worthy to even touch any harvest that God has made for Himself. I can only pinpoint to the one that has given His life to all of us. Your job and mine is not to save it. Yes, we are commissioned to preach the gospel. We are to tell them the salvation that God has. The saving business belongs to the Lord and to the Lord alone. There is a precious promise given to every child of God, and that is you, who faithfully sow the gospel seed. Therefore, child of God, each and every one of you, keep sowing. Keep watering. In the Lord's time, there will be harvest. Kung ang attitude mo is, what is my reward? Then you are not acting yet into that faith of God. The reward, let God to also do that for you. Minsan sinasabi ka natin, abonado na ako. Amen, Pastor? Nag-kumbita tayo ng tatlo, nagdala ka ng kasama. Yung kasama mo, nagdala pa ng kasama, malalakas din kumain. 120 isang tao, pero sabi ng iba, makauwi na ba? It's not about the money. It's about you hearing the word of God. napapagod po. Harvest is not an easy task. That's why God took it out from us. Let me repeat. Harvest is not an easy task. That's why God took it away from us. He says, Galatians chapter 6, verse 9 to 10, let us not become what? Doing weary, or becoming weary in doing good. For the proper time, we will reap a harvest if we do not give up. Therefore, as we have opportunity, let us do good to all people, especially to those who belong to the family of God. Harvesters. Now I'm calling you harvesters. Why is there a change of tone, Pastor? Are we not sowers? Yes, you are. But we are harvesters as well. To those who sow in tears will reap the songs of joy. You will not probably sing these songs right now because maybe those that you have planted or those that you have sown the seed, you will not be there to see it grow. But one day in heaven, you will see those same people sitting, praising, and worshiping the living God. Those who go out weeping, carrying the seed to sow. You see how difficult it is? We carry the seed to sow, weeping. That's the intensity of love that we have for others. That you are able to weep when you carry the seed to sow. Let's do evangelism. There should be that faith, that heaviness in your heart. Lord, these are the people that you love. That's why he used the word weeping, but will return with songs of joy. Hello? With songs of joy. Carrying this time, not the seed, but the sheaves, the tanggal na. Kumbaga sa talabat na deliver na. Kaya tayo masaya. Yan po ang harvest. And let me close with this illustration. You know what distinct is? Hindi po to Star Wars. Hello? How many of you know what is this? Don't answer me. Let me answer myself. Now, this is a facility in Norway. And this is what you called the Slavpod Global Seed Vault. Was constructed early 2006 and it started operation 2008. What is it about? This is a secure facility for the world's crop diversity. It is called the seed vault because it contains all types of food and plant-bearing seed in the world. Why? Because according to them, if something happens to the world, there might be a mismanagement, an accident, equipment failure, funding, war, sabotage, or doomsday, or natural disaster, the seeds that are here can be planted again. So life will continue. And in 2008, there are 320,549 seeds they have collected around the world. In 2003 or 2023, there are already more than 1,267,000 127 seeds. Why did I give you this? Man's desire is to continue to live. So therefore, whatever natural things that God has given, maybe we all put it together for us to survive. In your hands, there is a seed. The seed that will survive everything. Let me go to my last illustration. What is this right now? In 2023, last year, in Egypt, the tomb of an Egyptian queen named Merenneth in Abydos, they have excavated it, a 5,000 years old tomb with 5,000 years old wine jars. Many of these vessels were sealed. And with the stoppers still intact, yung takip po. And when they opened it, some even held the remains of well-preserved grape seeds. 5,000 years back. So what did they do? These seeds has been buried for thousands of years. You know, the scientists, they took the seed. They found and they planted in good soil. They watered the soil. They waited patiently. And after a time, these ancient seeds germinated and tiny plants pushed their way through the surface of the soil. These tender plants are now bearing fruits. Brothers and sisters, I have put you this illustration. We are so concerned of life after things that come by. There are seeds that will continue to live, but you have God's seed, the gospel, that is in your heart. Brothers and sisters, this is the power of the gospel. Seed. The seed we preach here today is no other than Jesus Christ. If you have never been saved, I'm speaking to those who have come here for the first time, maybe I can ask the praise and worship team. If you have never been saved by the grace of God, if you have never trusted Jesus Christ to be the Savior of your soul, you need to know that the gospel has the power to transform and give your life. If the Lord speaking to those of you about your spiritual condition, you know you need to come to Jesus. I'm offering you the seed. Today, this will be a good day for you to be saved. This seed that you will accept will germinate into your hearts, and the Lord will make you a fruitful plant for His glory. Now, for you others, the need to get about the business of telling others about Jesus. This would be a good day for you also to put aside all your excuses about why you cannot tell others about Jesus. This would be a good day for you to come before Him and make a commitment to the witness for His glory. And for the last, and for the others who are a little bit discouraged today because you think your prayers and your witness are in vain. Nothing could be further than the truth. Why don't you get down before the Lord today and talk to Him about your concerns? Ask Him to let you see a few sprouts in your field. If He has spoken to your hearts through this message, church, please let Him have His way in your heart and your life. Church, these are the essence of a true harvest. The joy of the harvest and the Lord of the harvest. Matthew 9:38, and I will close with this. It says there, pray therefore to the Lord of the harvest that you will be sent forth laborers unto His harvest. God is the Lord of our harvest. We cannot do anything more than that. But we can ask Him, Lord, here I am. Send me to the harvest. I hope you're getting the message today, church. This is what God wanted us to do. Mark chapter 4, verse 26 and 29, going back. This is what the kingdom of God is like. We sow seed on the ground, night and day, whether he sleeps or he gets up. The seeds sprout and grows, though he does not know how. All by itself, the soil produces grain, for the first stalk, then the head, and the full kernel in the head. And as soon as the grain is found, he puts the sickle to it, because the harvest has come. Church, it's a joyful harvest. It's a joyful harvest! Why? Because Jesus has been lifted up in this harvest. And that's what it's all about. The full season is pushed 24. I'd like to invite all of you to stand up. And I want you to pray with me right now. Maybe, if you don't mind, I know I'm asking too much from JICM. I'd like to invite our GICM workers to come here in front. All of you. Sige po. Sampu-sampu. Or dose-dose. Hindi po sa stage. Kaya lang sa stage. Yung kayo po dito. Tara. Lahat po nandiyan. Lapit po kayo. Lapit po kayo. Lapit. Dito. Dito sa harap. Pastor, please lead your people here. Come on, church. Dito. Dito sa harap. Nakaharap po sa akin. Come on. Amen. Sige po. Come on, church. Lahat po tayo. Sampu-sampu siguro isang line. Come on. Kayo, kapatid. Please, come forward. Kayo lahat, lahat. Lahat kayo. Dito po. Isang linya po. Dalawang linya, tatlong linya. Sige po, yung iba sa likod. Sige po. Doon pa po, dito. Sige po, kayo po. Because we will pray all together. We will pray all together. Sige po, please, pastor. Pastor, kaya ayoko na may nakadamit eh. Aba, parang slow motion lahat. Come on, pastor! Ito po, tatanggapin po natin si Lord. Amen! Tatanggapin po natin lahat dito. Please, pastor, come on. Dito po. Sige po, atras pa yung iba. Yan. Now, why are you here? Because this is a prayer of harvest. A prayer of thanksgiving. And a prayer for winning souls. I want you to pray with me, church, and all of you that are here today for this harvest prayer. Let's all bow down and lift our hands together. Pray with me right now. Lord Jesus, pray with me. Lord Jesus, I decree right now, in the name of Jesus, according to your word, that I will grow, I will reap, I will harvest. Lord, use my mouth to bring healing, to bring encouragement, to bring prophetic words, to lift up those that are discouraged. In the name of Jesus, I declare, this year I will win souls for Christ. I declare that I will move boldly in the Holy Spirit, and I will be able to hear what the Holy Spirit speaks to me, and I will move in with boldness and confidence because of Jesus. And I declare, I say, yes, Lord, you are my Lord. I declare victory. I declare blessing. I declare right now the abundance in Jesus' name. I declare healing in the name of Jesus. Because of your word, it will come to pass in my life. Here I am, Lord, and again, I say yes, Lord, and hallelujah. Amen, in Jesus' name. And all God's children say, amen, amen, hallelujah. Praise God. You may all be seated. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.